Anderson Cooper 360, weeknights at 8 and 10 on CNN.
Miles down an unpaved path in Wyoming to a top secret and remote location Pete Larson escorts us to. A first of a kind find.
Here's the dig.
An archaeological dream for America's most prolific fossil hunter.
There's a bone over here.
Bones, skulls, jaws, jutting out of millions years old earth.
I'm worried I'm gonna step on something.
If you step where there's no, where you, the white is, you're okay. That's obviously a rib bone.
This is a rib bone.
Yep.
Is that a tooth?
No, that's a horn.
That's a horn.
That's a horn, right. These are the three horned face is what triceratops means.
And, wow.
The triceratops, the lumbering vegetarian that graces history museums. A creature of wonder recreated in Jurassic Park. Larson believes these enormous bones were cracked and crushed by the meat-loving Tyrannosaurus Rex, who fed and discarded them at this feed site. For the first time in modern paleontology, three of them unearthed at the same site. At the painstaking weeks-long excavation, these scientists believe one of the dinosaurs may rival the most complete skeleton of a triceratops ever found.
How old is this that I'm touching?
67 million years old.
67 million years old, that's amazing.
A living animal that's like nothing that's alive today, which is just one of the coolest things in the world.
It is an addiction?
Oh, it's an addiction. Here, it's right. Once you start doing this, you can't stop.
The only time this independent fossil collector stopped digging, when he went to federal prison. In 1990, he paid a rancher to unearth the world's largest complete fossil of a T-Rex on the rancher's land. Larson named it Sioux. Later, the rancher, the U.S. government, and the Sioux Indians all claimed possession. The government seized the T-Rex, and Larson was sent to prison for 2 years for illegal transport of money. Those in support of Larson call the sentence an example of government overreach, using murky anthropological laws. Sioux was sold at auction to Chicago's Field Museum for $8 million. Larson never saw a cent.
How do you come back and keep digging?
That was not fun, but it's still part of my life. And I learned many things, things I didn't have a curiosity about, like what's life in prison like.
But it won't stop this fiercely independent scientist. New federal laws put in place after Larson's T-Rex battle now say the landowner, not the government, owns fossils. Larson has already struck a modest deal with this rancher and a museum in the Netherlands for the Triceratops trio for far less than he would have made at a public auction. Larson stresses he's not in it for the money, but the hunt.
And they're monsters, true monsters that were alive. And to be able to hunt for those monsters is pretty cool.
That is pretty cool. Kyung Lau joins me now. Kyung, what's next? How long until the bones of our triceratops there are removed?
Well, it's going to take at least a couple more weeks, John, if not longer, to try to get all of those bones out. They're still in the process of discovering exactly how many bones are in there, so they still have a lot of work ahead. But then, once in the lab, it becomes even more difficult. They're looking at up to 20,000 hours trying to piece it together before it's in a form that you can take your kid to see it in a museum.
Oh, wow. And you called the man you profiled there, Pete Larson, prolific. Define that. How many dinosaur skeletons has Pete found?
Believe it or not, nearly 100, if you count skulls as full dinosaurs. I mean, 100 dinosaurs. And that's his real argument to critics. Yes, he's an independent guy, but were it not for Larson, then perhaps the discoveries he's made in the last 30 years or so, we simply wouldn't have them.